Baruch Hashem, tonight we have a tremendous chus. The Mashkiach, Ramatasso, Solomon Shlito, who we went first to with this idea. And it was the Mashkiach who wrote the original Askama that so many other Gedoyli Yisrael signed on to. Ramatasso, Solomon Shlito is such a person. As busy as Rebbe is, he has time for each and every single Yid. We are honored that the Mashkiach has joined us this evening, Ramatasso, Solomon Shlito.
A few minutes. I was zoicha to sit here together with you. I think I've absorbed already the whole ruach. The ruach ha-toira. The ruach ha-emuna. The ruach ha-bitochen, which characterizes the whole movement of A-Time. This is not an ordinary Sir Mashas. It's a demonstration of our emuna in the potency of Torah. In the fact that Torah is Torah's Chaim, in the fact that Torah is the greatest chus that we have for ourselves, for our children, and for others, and for everyone. In Ne'ila of Yom Kippur, we say the Pizman, where we bemoan the fact that we're in Golus, where we bemoan the fact that we've lost the Beis Hamikdash. Ir HaKodesh HaMechuzos, all the holiness has left us. But in a desperation, on the one hand, and confidence, on the other hand, we say to Hashem Yisbarach, Ein Shiur Rak HaToyra Hazois. We have nothing left. Rak HaToyra Hazois. But what we mean to say is, the Torah represents everything else that we are missing. The Torah makes up for it. Ein Shiur Rak HaToyra Hazois. I think this evening we are celebrating the fact that Ein Shiur Rak HaToyra Hazois. We appreciate the Torah for what it is. And we have been using the Torah. Although Chazal tell us, Ein Misrapim B'Divrei Torah. We can't use Divrei Torah as a refuah, just to mumble words of Torah and hope that they should have an effect for a refuah. But if we learn Torah, if we toil in Torah, if we give away effort for Torah, and Mekai in the midst of Talmud Torah, Keneged Kulam, then the Torah is able to protect us. And then the Torah becomes a potent force of refuah. And especially when we sit down with expressed intention of wanting our learning to be a schus for those in Klal Yisrael who are looking for Yeshua, then this is a miraculous demonstration of emuna. A time stands for hope. Bitochen in the Rebbeinu Shel Olam, Rabbeinu Yonah explains, the word bitochen itself, we use it to mean trust. But Rabbeinu Yonah says, you can only trust in words of Hashem Yisbarach. Then you can be sure that these words will be fulfilled. But if you haven't heard a message from Hashem Yisboach, what are you trusting in? Rabbi Yonah says, the word bitochen means hope. Kol asher yechuba el hachayim yesh bitochen. That's the posuk. Yesh bitochen means there's, as long as there's life, there's hope. The godliness of a Yid is they never lose hope. Ani tomid ayachel. Continuously I'm hoping, David HaMelech says. Ani tomid ayachel. Vasaper kol nifloi secho. And after my hope, I will be able to tell over your praises. The more one hopes, the stronger one hopes become. We don't become frustrated, but we carry on hoping. And he told me dayachir. And indeed, always, Be'ezah Hashem Yisborach, when he realizes his hopes, he's full of praises from the Ribbono Shel Olam. No complaints how long I had to wait for my hopes to be fulfilled. Appreciating the Ribbono Shel Olam, for at the end of it all, letting me realize my hopes and let me achieve that was I was hoping for in life. This combination of continuous hope with which every Yid identifies with, and which Eitan represents and encourages and supports and gives hope to people, combined with the realization that Ein Shiur Rak HaToyro Azois, that the last thing that we have to do is to call upon the Zchus HaToyro, to tap in on the wonderful source of life that the Ribbono Shel Olam has given us, and which after taking everything away from us, this keeps us going and represents everything of Kedusha, everything of Rotzon HaBorei, everything that we hope for. And we're using the Koyach HaTorah for the schools of those who are begging Hashem Yisboach for Rachmonas. This demonstration makes its mark in Klal Yisrael. It makes its mark in Shemayim. It makes its mark on every neshama that has taken part in this wonderful, wonderful undertaking. The boy in Shemayim should take a help. Give a bracha. Inoyem Hashem alchem aleichem, mas yedeitem koin neil. Ribbono Shel Olam should give bracha to the success of the movement. It's not an organization, it's a movement. The movement of Eitan, which brings so much hope to so many people and has today provided us all with a new perspective of how to appreciate Torah and how to understand the history of Klal Yisrael, who are left with nothing. Ein shiur rak ha-Torah azois. And this nothing is everything.